Okay. So let's do this a bit more of the correct way. The last time I compared these two cards, I left the graphic settings and all of the tests turned down low. Those were the settings I used to test low-end CPUs or GPUs. I wanted to see how these would compare with those settings. But this time, let's crank it up. I'll be once again running all these tests on my Threadripper, which this time is mildly overclocked. I know many have said in the previous video that this Threadripper wasn't good for gaming and could cause a bottleneck. And they were right in some ways. The Threadripper's strength is its many cores and therefore threads, and not the performance of the individual threads. Many of these games don't take advantage of an absurd amount of threads, so yeah, it might not be the greatest. But it's good enough for what we're looking at, and it's probably the best thing I have at the moment. The GPUs, once again, are a GTX 1650 versus a GTX 1080 Ti. Both running at stock clocks, and yes, they aren't even in the same ballpark. Two very different cards, but I wanted to see how they stacked up against each other. So let's get to it. First off, let's check NVENC encoding. Now, the performance is very similar. However, the 1650 does actually pull ahead slightly here. The 1650 encoded on average 6.7 FPS faster than the 1080. So on to 3D rendering. In Heaven, with everything set to extreme, the 1080 averaged about 100 FPS faster and maxed out at about 180 FPS faster. Now, as you notice, I am running these each at 1920 by 1080. Yes, the 1080 Ti could go to 4K. However, with the limited memory of the 1650, that could cause some issues. So to keep it fair, I'm sticking with 1920 by 1080 on both for all tests. In superposition, once again, set to extreme, the 1080 obliterates the 1650, averaging nearly 30 FPS on average faster and scoring nearly 4,000 points higher. But one thing you'll notice so far is that although the 1650 is averaging a much lower frame rate, it's still looking pretty good. Knock a couple of the settings down and it would easily be back up around 30 FPS. And you know, I gotta give credit where credit's due. Running the Cyberpunk benchmark, with the settings cranked, the 1080 Ti averaged around 62 FPS, nearly double that of the 1650. Again, however, if all you had was the 1650, you could easily get by. Want a higher frame rate? Well, just drop a few of the settings or set them to dynamic, and you'll be good to go. The Crysis Remastered benchmark showed the 1080 averaging over double the average frame rate of the 1650. Yet, even at the high settings, the 1650 still managed to average around 30 FPS. Now, BeamNG was interesting. Yes, the 1080 averaged a higher frame rate, but just slightly. You'll notice the 1650's usage is around 100%, while the 1080, well, was around 50%. So there's definitely a bottleneck somewhere. Forza Motorsport 7's bench showed the 1080 averaging around 110 FPS, while the 1650, at the same settings, was back slightly at 85 FPS. Now, GTA 4, the 1080 averaged only about 10 FPS faster, but like BeamNG, you can see the GPU usage is fairly low on the 1080, so there's definitely a bottleneck. And we need to also remember that this is GTA 4. It didn't exactly use the most efficient engine, and okay, well, it was a piece of garbage, but the game itself was great. Now, when GTA 5 came out, for those that, you know, weren't around then to experience it, it was a night and day difference when compared to GTA 4. You could actually run this game on systems that didn't require you to remortgage your home just to purchase them. And here, well, the 1080 averaged over double the frame rate of the 1650. Now, the 1650 averaged 44 FPS at high settings, which I think is pretty good. But the 1080, as you can see, wasn't even breaking a sweat. I'll let the last segment of the benchmark run side by side here, so if you want to watch and compare. Unreal Tournament 3, well, it's an older game, but it was great in its time. And you can see here that neither of the GPUs were even trying. Both did great, but the 1080 once again pulled ahead and averaged about 160 FPS higher. And yeah, Portal 2. Well, as you can see, there was again a bottleneck somewhere, as both averaged almost the exact same frame rate. However, 292 FPS, personally, I'd be perfectly okay living with that frame rate. Now, I couldn't compare any of the previous results here with the current results since I used different settings this time. But regardless, you can see that in both Heaven and Superposition, there was a 100% difference between the two cards, and similar results for many of the other tests. GTA 4, BMNG, and Portal 2, well, there was a bottleneck somewhere, and that caused the 1080 to, you know, not reach its full potential. However, the results we got were still pretty damn good anyways. Well, as usual, I try to keep it as quick and to the point as possible. As always, if you made it this far, I want to thank you, and I hope that all is going well in your world, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.